The best thing I've done as far as a green screen is getting an actual like solid screen and not a sheet. So I have this green screen right here, and then I have these three softbox lights in front of me. I have the two lights facing me, and then I have one kind of on the side coming to me. And then I have two cameras set up depending on what I want to do. So sometimes I have the camera right here that's on the top of my computer if I wanted to like sit down in this chair. And then I also have this other camera set up here on a tripod. And this camera looks a little weird. It's a teleprompter camera. And see, if I shine this in here, I have like a Logitech camera that's, it's set up inside of this box. Which way am I facing? Okay. It's set up inside of this box here. And so there's a teleprompter app for my phone, and I place my phone right in here, and then it kind of reflects up and into me. And so that, and it kind of like reverses the text and does some weird stuff with lenses. So that way I can be reading off a teleprompter screen, which is my phone screen reflected up in here. But then the web camera just peeks right through without it seeing the screen. It's magical. So when I can sit down here and I can be in front of my green screen, or I can switch up to just facing the green screen right there, and I can be seeing myself on the camera here, and I can be standing right here and reading off of the green screen. Now, how do I get the green screen video actually filmed? Well, glad you asked. So this is called OBS Studio at obsproject.com. It's free Mac or Windows version. We install it. And then what I can do here, well, let me just show you what it looks like at first. So here's me right here on the podcast setting, and I have a green screen behind me, but as you can see, I can just drop in whichever kind of background I want right behind me, and I can position my microphone right up in there. Or actually, what I like to do that's fun sometimes is to do an alt drag and just kind of have the microphone right up in here. But you see how I've cropped it out, so now I can really be here in the frame. And so how do we do this? Well, we use OBS, and we click on this plus sign where the scenes are, and we just add a new scene. And then over here in the sources, we click on plus and add a source, and we want to add a video capture device. And either you choose a new one, or I have an existing one, and I believe it is my webcam. What? Oh, is that the right? Yeah, I think that's the right one. So here's my webcam, and let me kind of reposition this. So here, I need to kind of backpedal a little bit. So let me cheat a little bit. Okay, so we put our web camera right here, right? And you see how it's like, it's got way too much, right? It's got all the background and everything. So what we do is we, first of all, we can go to the edge and hold down Alt, and then just sort of trim the parts that we don't want so that we kind of keep in the green screen and maybe even the bottom there, right? So now I just have the part of me that I want. But you see how there's like a black border around everything? So we just drag it to the edge and enlarge it. That way we're sort of zoomed in, and that way we take up most of the area. And maybe I'll even kind of position myself, not right at the very top, but a little bit further down. So that's the first step, right? It's to trim the edges. But then how do we remove this green screen right behind us? Well, here's what we do. Is first we go to settings, and we make sure that this one checkbox is unchecked. Hide OBS windows from a screen capture. This costed me a lot of time. So make sure that this is unchecked. You can always check it back in later. This will come into play in a moment. And then you can go to this web camera source. You right-click it and choose Filters, and then under Effect Filters, we click the plus and choose Chroma Key. Now we've chosen the Chroma Key, and it might even have a pretty good guess about, because it now needs to know like what color it to remove. And I think by default, it just tries to do green, which like does a pretty good job, but you see there's some kind of like green fuzz around my head. So what we want to do instead
is do custom color, but instead of just this bright lime green, we do select color. And then here's the most, well, here's what we do next. We need to make sure to not do the effect. So click on the eyeball. So we're back to default. And why? Because we do select color and then pick screen color. And this way we are just hovering around our this green here and without it having processed it. So hover over, put the cursor around. You can see on this bottom, there's this HTML code and it's like 84, 7. And then we just kind of try to find the closest match. And this might be a good opportunity for you to adjust your lights. Like if we hover over on this side, it's 8 something. Hover over there, it's 7. If it's way different, then that's not good. But let's just try to kind of click on some kind of color here. So we chose whatever that green color is. And then we turn the eyeball back on. Oh no, we're gone. And that just means we need to adjust our settings here, because you see if it's way too high, we're completely gone. But if way too low, there's like this static. Looks like we're on Bunny Ears TV. So we just kind of inch it ahead a little bit. And then as far as the smoothness, you really don't need more than like 25 or so. So we just kind of adjust this until we get this happy medium that we like. And personally, I find that I readjust this like every couple of weeks just because it's never quite the way I want. And so that's your problem, right? To figure out your camera and your lighting until it's just the way you want. And then we can close that. And now we've removed the background, but what's the problem? Well, it's this black behind us. So this is when we can click on the plus sign again and then choose image and then add an image. And then browse to whatever you have around that you can use as a background. And so I personally have a folder called Video Backgrounds where I just have these different kinds of images, like say the beach. And so here's this image, but oh no, where are we? We see that the order of these layers matters. So we drag the image down there. Ooh, cool, there I am. And then, there's this little piece of my microphone. So I can either adjust that or I can just click on myself again and do a hold down alt and take care of that little bit right there. And it can become a lot of fun for you because we can pile up many images here and then just use the eyeball to click and change it. We can do, I believe, color source. So if you want to do a solid color, similar idea, right? If we want to do like a fuchsia or something, we can click on that and then drag it below ourselves. And here we go. Now I'm in a solid color. And then we can even add a video. So click on this plus and say, I want to add media source. And then we can browse to, so we have like the rain or we have like the news background. That's fun. And then we can click on loop to make this always play in a loop. And we drag it down below us. And then we maybe change the size so it fits. So there we go. Now I'm like a newscaster. And that's what you can do with OBS. And one final adjustment that I think is really important is you right-click on this camera and go to Properties. And if you can find any sort of setting, maybe you can't find it. So this part's on you, but if you can remove any sort of low light filter or like, yeah, so I went into the properties and I go configure video and it props up this extra stuff. And in the camera control, definitely uncheck the low light compensation because this will like adjust your colors on you and the green screen will not stay consistent. So properties, configure video, camera control, low light compensation, if you have that sort of setting available to you. And that is how you can get a green screen set up in OBS. Like I said, the way I have it set up is here's me when I'm sitting. And I like the blue background the best. And then when I'm standing, I have this spokesperson setting. And then what I can do is pull out, I think I need to turn it off and on. I have this camera here that's on the tripod. And then I can just be standing right here and center myself. And then you see how there's this start recording to record an MP4 or start virtual camera to pipe it through Zoom or even start streaming. So I would just hit start recording and make sure here's my microphone. And then I can just be standing right here and right there and do the green screen video using OBS Studio, which is free software. This is Robert Plank, and have fun on your green screen.